our prayer come before your Lord as the incense, and the lifting up of our hands as the evening sacrifice.
O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Psalms 47 and 48.
Clap your hands, all your peoples. Shout to God with a cry of joy. For the Lord Most High is to be feared. He is a great King over. He subdues the peoples under us, and the nations under our feet. He chooses our inheritance for us, even the pride of Jacob whom he loves. God has gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of the ram's horn. Sing praise to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our King, sing praises. For God is King of all the earth. Sing praises with all your skill. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne. The nobles of the peoples have gathered together with the people of the God of Abraham. The rulers of the earth belong to God, and he is highly exalted. Great is the Lord and highly to be praised. In the city of our God is his holy hill. Beautiful and lofty, the joy of all the earth is the hill of Zion. The very center of the world and the city of the great King. God is in her citadels. He is known to be her sure refuge. Behold, the kings of the earth assemble and march forward together. They looked and were astounded. They retreated and fled in terror. Trembling seized them there. They rise like a woman in childbirth, like ships of the sea when the east wind shatters them. As we have heard, so have we seen, the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God. God has established her forever. We have waited in silence on your loving kindness, O God. In the midst of your temple, your praise, like your name, O God, reaches to the world's end. Your right hand is full of justice. Let Mount Zion be glad, and the cities of Judah rejoice. Because of your judgments, make the circuit of Zion, walk round about her. Count the number of her towers. Consider well her bulwarks. Examine her strongholds, that you may tell those who come after. This is our God forever and ever. He shall be our guide forevermore. Glory to the Father and to the Son
Genesis, the 15th chapter, beginning at the first verse. After these things, the word of the Lord came to Abram in vision. Do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield. Your reward shall be very great. But Abram said, O Lord God, what will you give me? For I continue childless, and the heir of my house is Eliezer of Damascus. And Abram said, You have given me no offspring, and so a slave born in my house is to be my heir. But the word of the Lord came to him, This man shall not be your heir. No one but your very own issue shall be your heir. He brought him outside and said, Look toward heaven and count the stars, if you are able to count them. And then he said to him, So shall your descendants be. And he believed the Lord, and the Lord reckoned it to him as righteousness. Then he said to him, I am the Lord, who brought you from Ur of the Chaldeans, to give you this land to possess. But he said, O Lord God, how am I to know that I shall possess it? He said to him, Bring me a heifer 3 years old, a female goat 3 years old, a ram 3 years old, a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. He brought him all these and cut them in two, laying each half over against the other. But he did not cut the birds in two. And when the birds of prey came down on the carcasses, Abram drove them away. When the sun had gone down and it was dark, a smoking firepot and a flaming torch passed between the pieces. On that day, the Lord made a covenant with Abram, saying, To your descendants I give this land, from the river of Egypt to the great river, the river Euphrates, the land of the Kenites, the Kenizzites, the Kadmonites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Rephaim, the Amorites, the Canaanites, the Girgashites, and the Jebusites. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Domine si tuis potes me mundae, et adit Jesus volo. Magnificat anima mea Dominum, et exultavit spiritus meus in Deo salutari meo, qui ad expexit humilitatem ansile sue, ex enim ex hoc beatam medis et omnes generationem, qui affecit mi magna qui potens est, et sanctum nomen eius, et misericordia eius a progenie in progenies, timentibus eum, fecit potentiam in brachio suo, dispersit superbus mente cordis sui, deposuit potentes dexere, et exaltavit humiles, est orientes implevit bonis, et divites dimisit inanes, susceptit Israel puerum suum, recordatus misericordiae suae, sicut locutus est ad patres nostros, Abraham et semini eius in saecula. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et sempre,
Gospel of Mark, the 6th chapter, beginning at the 1st verse. Jesus left that place and came to his hometown, and his disciples followed him. On the Sabbath he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard were astounded. They said, "Where did this man get all this? What is this wisdom that has been given to him? What deeds of power are being done by his hands? Is not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, and brother of James, and Joseph, and Judas, and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us also?" And they took offense at him. Then Jesus said to them, "Prophets are not without honor except in their hometown, and among their own kin, and in their own house." And he could do no deed of power there, except that he laid his hands on a few sick people and cured them. And he was amazed at their unbelief. Then he went about among the villages teaching. He called the 12 and began to send them out two by two, and gave them authority over the unclean spirits. He ordered them to take nothing for their journey except a staff, no bread, no bag, no money in their belts, but to wear sandals and not to put on two tunics. He said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave that place. If any place will not welcome you and they refuse to hear you, as you leave, shake off the dust that is on your feet as a testimony against them." So they went out and proclaimed that all should repent. They cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Nunc dimittis servum tuum, Domine, secundum verbum tuum in pace, quia viderunt oculi mei, salutare tuum, quod parasti, ante faciem omnium populorum, lumen ad revelationem censium, et gloriam plebis tuae Israel. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world. For only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care, and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. Give us grace, O Lord, to answer readily the call of our Saviour Jesus Christ, and to proclaim to all people the good news of his salvation, that we in the whole world may perceive the glory of his marvellous works, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. are the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works. Give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, be delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness, through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour. Amen. Be a light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
God, the life of all who live, the light of the faithful, the strength of those who labour, and the repose of the dead. We thank you for the blessings of the day that has passed, and humbly ask for your protection through this coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning light, through him who died and rose again for us, even your Son, Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. Today the Church remembers Florence Lee Timoy, the first woman priest in the Anglican Communion, ordained priest in Hong Kong during the Second World War. It thanks for her ministry, for her trailblazing of the way of female clergy in the Anglican Communion. O God, our Heavenly Father, who raised up your faithful servant, Florence Lee Timoy, to be a pastor in your church and to feed your flock, give abundantly to all pastors the gifts of your Holy Spirit, that they may minister in your household as true servants of Christ and stewards of your divine mysteries. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God and Father of all, whom thou art heavens adore, let the whole earth also worship you, all nations obey you, all tongues confess and bless you, and men and women everywhere love you and serve you in peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore.